To answer your question about how resource teachers can gain access to the homeroom teachers' courses and students, so the best way that we can do that is have the resource teacher be added to the course by the teacher. And then what's even better is that within that course, you can create a grading group. Or the small group for the resource teacher to be able to work with within that course in Schoology. So I'm going to show you how that can be done. All right, so the first thing you need to do in Schoology is come up to courses, and then the homeroom teacher needs to pick the course that they want to add the resource teacher to. So I'm adding my resource teacher to my UC Schoology training series. And to add that resource teacher, I'm coming over to the left-hand side menu bar and I'm clicking on members. And from here, I'm going to click on add members. And I'm going to add my resource teacher to this course now. So Mr. Benetti is my resource teacher. I'm going to click on him and then I'm going to click on add members. Now, right now, I added him to my course, but he is not an admin, meaning he doesn't see this course or have the same capabilities as a teacher would in this course. So I need to make him an admin so he has teacher capabilities. So to do that, I'm going to scroll down and find him. And then across from his name, going towards the right, there's that gear shift. Clicking on that gear, I'm going to change to make admin. And now Mr. Benetti, after I confirm, is an admin to my course. So he is technically a co-teacher of my course and he has access to my students. But what we can do is we can make a small group for him. And as you can see, I already created one, but I'm just going to delete this so that I can show you how to create it from scratch. So coming over here to the right-hand side, you'll see where it says organize members into grading groups. When I hover my mouse over that little box, I can click on add grading group. So basically what I'm doing is I'm creating a small group. It's going to be Mr. Benetti's students. So I'm going to call it Mr. Benetti's group. Okay. And then I'm just going to select the students from my student list here that he has in his group. And then once I'm finished, I'm going to click Create Grading Group. So now you see over here on the right-hand side, Mr. Benetti's group is now has now populated. So a couple of things we can do if for some reason you needed to remove somebody from the group, just click on the group title. And the members pop up, and to remove somebody, you just click on the X across to the right of their name. And now you've removed from that group. Now, if you wanted to add more people to the group, clicking on the gear, clicking on edit, now I'm able to choose more people and click on create grading group. And now I have seven people in my grading group. Okay, and then to delete the group altogether, I just click on the gear shift and the edit, I'm sorry, the delete button, and that will remove the group and all of its members. So now, if Mr. Benetti wants to create something for his group in materials, he could potentially add, say, an assignment. So clicking on adding an assignment, okay, what he would need to do to add after he filled in all the information that he wanted to for his assignment, right? Coming down here, it says options individually assigned. So right now that's not activated. We need to click on that to activate that. And what that does is it brings up this dialogue, this field here that you can type in. And if I start typing Mr., and then you'll see Mr. Benetti's group comes up. So now I'm just assigning this assignment to his group. Okay, I hope this helps.